Hey, welcome back, Rankers. It's Melbourne Cup Day today, and in Melbourne, we get to have a public holiday because of a horse race, which is kind of nice. I didn't go to the Melbourne Cup, and it's it's 5:30 in the afternoon here, so there'll be a few people staggering home from the Melbourne Cup. It's never a pleasant journey coming home from the Melbourne Cup on a day like today, which is quite warm and just a little bit sultry. And I'm recording from home, so if you hear a hum in the background, that's the air conditioner going, so sorry about that. I want to talk to you today a little bit about the webinar that we did last week. Thank you so much for everyone attending. We had about 250 sign up. We had 150 get onto the webinar, and then we had about another 100 that couldn't. We haven't heard from all the ones that couldn't. We've heard from a lot of the ones that couldn't get on, so I'm sorry for that. Citrix said we could do 250 people, and that's how many we registered, and then the system couldn't handle it. So sorry about that. But we're going to be doing them monthly. So if there's something you want to see in that, and I've already been given a couple of ideas about the sorts of things that people want to see, the feedback's been great. So thank you. I know I haven't responded to you all. But I wanted to talk to a little bit about the post that we got ranked last week and what's happened since then with that ranking. So the phrase that we wanted to rank for last week was "Welcome back, Rankers." I've never actually written it down anywhere. I've only ever just said it in the video. And I know that some of you are probably asking, what about Google captions? Well, Google's auto captioning does not understand a word I say, so I've never done that. But so I thought I'd better rank for it. So that's what we did during the webinar last week. So I wrote the post 10 minutes before the webinar went live, posted it, and then within about 15 minutes, we were ranked number one. Now, obviously, not a difficult phrase to rank for, non-competitive. In fact, you can see some of the results there. Really, the only one that is actually mentioning the phrase is this post here. So all the rest, I'm going to sneeze, so I'm going to cut. That's better. So since then, so this is the page or the result that was ranked number one within 20 minutes, 15, 20 minutes of posting live. And great. But since then, we've got this one, we've got this one, and we've got an image. So I said last week at the webinar, you know, giving your images descriptive file names is not only great for SEO, it helps Google understand whether they should be in Google image search or not as well. And there you go, that is the image from the actual post page. So there is stark evidence that bang, it's in image search. Now that didn't happen straight away, so image search seems to take longer to update, and I guess, you know, Google image search bot hadn't crawled the page at the same time. I don't know. Anyway, it took longer. The other thing that is of note is that we've got four results now, essentially, for that one phrase. Now, Google doesn't like doing that for the most part. It doesn't like having multiple results from the same site. However, in this case, because it is a relatively non-competitive phrase, then there's not a lot of other sites that are relevant for that phrase. So Google's found it, or the essence of that, on our site several times. Now, the reason it's done that, I've only written the post once, right? The reason it's done that, and it'll be interesting to see this again in about 3 weeks, because I'm using WordPress Thesis, and I have, if we're just going to have a look at this post, I have a widget, like a lot of people who have WordPress have on their site, and the widget basically says, hey, latest from the blog. So you can see here, we've got the webinar post. In fact, I don't even know who wrote that post. Oh, you know, I wrote that post. sorry, we've got a few writers on the blog. But this is the one that I wrote for the webinar, right? And there's that image. So you can see here, we've got this widget here that refers back to that. So this page that I'm on is the actual post page. If I go to the blog, which is ranking number two for the phrase, right, we've got it most recent posts. We've got "Welcome Back, Rankers" in a link here. We've got welcome back rankers in this widget again here on this blog page, so you can see the URL /blog. And then we've got it down here as well as the blog continues. The other place that we've got it, now you might say, oh, Jim, isn't that duplicate content? Well, no. Well, actually, technically, yes. But Google doesn't see it that way because of the way that we've got the blog set up. Okay, we're using canonical tags and all those sorts of things. This is only a snippet of information here, so it's not really enough to make Google go, well, you've got five pages all the same. So this page is back at the blog post. And the other one that was ranking was the author page. And once again, I'm not saying welcome back rankers on the author, on my author page. It just so happens that it's here in this widget. So essentially, there are multiple pages out there on the site that are ranking or have the phrase on the page through the use of this widget. Now, the interesting thing is, why those pages? I suspect those pages because they will have the greatest page rank. Maybe not. I haven't even checked their page rank. In fact, probably should. Google PageRank, what's that? That's a 3. That's a 3. Can't even get my glasses on. That's a 3, and the blog post page would be a 3 as well. So they're both 3s. So maybe out of the pages that Google found on the site that had welcome back rankers on the page, it chose those ones because they had the highest page rank. It could have very well have chosen, you know, another 50 blog posts that also had that little bit of information on the page. But those pages are probably the ones that have got the most authority within the site as well. So, for instance, blog, the menu item, appears on every page. So every page is backlinking to the blog. The other thing is that every post has linked back to the author. So the author page is quite authoritative as well. And it is, so it's got it here, plus then it's got the link in every post. So Google's saying the author page, the blog page, they're probably, you know, quite authoritative given the structure of this site. The important thing to remember with this is that every site's different, every CMS is different. So people often say, why is that guy ranking and we're not? And usually within the first month. And usually you have to go through a discussion to explain that that's a very different site. If we spent all our time sitting down trying to work out why that site was ranking and yours wasn't, we wouldn't be actually working on getting your site ranking. So whenever you go into these things, don't fall into the trap of going, why is he not? Why? I mean, there is a good argument for going and analysing competitors. Don't have a problem with that. But don't fall into the trap of going, why? I can't seem to get above this guy. Just focus on your own site. Publish good content. Do what you know works. Like, there's certain SEO phrases that we don't rank number one for, and I'd like to for bragging rights, but not so much for the traffic that comes from those phrases, because they tend to be tire kickers and very price sensitive and not our market, essentially. But I'm not going to go and spend a whole lot of time, effort and money on those phrases or try to work out why people above me are above me. For the most part, I know anyway. It's that they're buying backlinks still. So despite the Penguin updates, what tends to happen in this situation, people have bought backlinks. A lot of them have been smashed. A lot of the SEO companies, local SEO companies, have been smashed. Some of them haven't. And what seems to be happening now is exact match domain, where you have, say, the key phrase is actually in the domain, is more important than ever right now since the last Penguin update, because backlinking has been smashed again. So exact match domain right now is really big. But if you go out and throw your eggs into that basket, Google's going to pull that lever and you're gone again. So hopefully that was helpful. Hopefully you won a few dollars if you had a bet on the Melbourne Cup, and we'll see you next week. Thanks very much. Bye.